Basket Live 2.0, back at you. The best is back, best is back. With the big homie, with the Cuddy.
What's up?
Come on, man.
Huh? Oh, come on, man. It's me, Roach. I'm the one that filmed the videos and everything.
You did?
You know, I edit the videos.
Your IG?
Yeah, follow me on IG. Just the topic, JustTheTopic. I will leave a link in the description for that. And also follow,
Basquiat. At Basquiat_Yaramaya. He would put that in the description, you know, on the video so y'all could. Basquiat_Yaramaya. Jeremiah in Hebrew. Basquiat Live 2.0. Just want to give a shout out. And shout out to this man right here. This great, this doctor, this legend. This. Great man, this influent, this educated man, and this great man for the black human race that came through the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. I want to give thanks and I want to give my prayers to the Most High, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai. We live through the Most High in Christ, so this is why we're doing this. So, Basquiat Live 2.0, subscribe now, share now, like now, share. We dropping more videos. You did. We crazy busy, Justin.
Yeah.
Tell them how busy you is, man.
I'm busy, man.
I'm busy.
I just got home.
And tell how much weight you lost.
I lost about 55 pounds.
We doing a video on that too. You lost a lot of weight.
I lost about 55.
Big testimony to a lot of people who can't beat that. But I got a lot of 2.0. But I want to do this quick video on the great Dr. Dick Gregory. That, how much he did for black people. What he sacrificed his life for. And the disrespect on his name. And the disregard on his name that nobody's... We went to YouTube, huh, Broach? We went to YouTube. We always watch YouTube. You know, YouTube, the new TV. We ain't seen nothing on Dick Gregory. You know what I mean? You might see some, like when he first, you know, went to the Father. We seen a little whatever. But now it's just like, come on, put some respect on his name. Let's come together. Let's see what we could do. And start an academy in his name. I know one's gonna come for the white people or certain white people who, you know, live by that agenda, you know, take black faces and make white coins off it, whatever. So let's not wait for another company or whatever big company of Fortune 500 company come in and swoop down and the Dick Gregory Academy for whatever black people, and they getting all black people money and making their people richer. Let us come from his family. From, you know, anybody, and I want to give condolences to his family. That thank y'all for producing a great man and letting that man be what he needed to be to the world. And with all the stripes and struggles and everything he went through, the Most High, I will guarantee you that it won't go in vain unless he was in vain. But I don't think he was in vain. I think that was a very big educated man that we really need to pay attention about. And we really need to give our respects about. That's why I really wanted to do this video, man. I really want to pay the respects to his family. I really want to tell them and tell, you know, even for him, that was a man that I really wanted to meet it, that we all really wanted to meet it. And the great things that he did for the civil rights movement, even being an entrepreneur and being great in business. What you saw him, bro? Like, he was
what caught my eye is, I didn't even know he was about the nutrition thing. He helped a lot of people lose weight. And back in the 80s, this video was like a documentary showing like how he was back then, you know, and how he was until his death. But he helped a lot of people as far as nutrition. And he even fasted for like 2 years.
2 years he fasted. That's
for the Vietnam War.
That he served? He served in the Vietnam War?
He didn't serve.
He didn't serve, but he always promoted being independent, going to work for yourself. And if you do go to a university or educational college or tech college, whatever like that, utilize the utilize the tools and the information and the education and bar yourself up to be someone in control of your own destiny and your own business, that you don't have to be a slave to the system by just making your own way and using your own mind and education for what you know and what you got, and making something big out of yourself. As far as black people, he did it for, so we can have that understanding that we don't have to go slave for everything in the world just to look good on the weekend, or just to look like whatever how we need to look on these certain days, that we could big ourselves up right now and utilize all the information and all the education and the great discipline that it takes for one to be great in this world. But we wanted to do this great video on Dick Gregory, man. Dr. Dick Gregory, man. That he did a lot for black people. He did a lot for the world, you know what I'm saying? He was never no uppity man. He even had conversation with the great Malcolm X about his assassination and people trying to come get him, and what the great Malcolm X did to sacrifice for us. Cause one thing, you can say anything about it, man, but when a man willing to die for the truth, that gotta speak volumes to the Most High. So people can say whatever they can say about these great men behind their back or after they gone and they living in heaven, or they living with the Most High in peace and waiting on the day of judgment like we all is, like the Father said, that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess on that day. So that's saying that everybody in these generations will have to be accountable for what they did and what they done, you know. And he knew we was the chosen ones. He knew we was the chosen people. Y'all know we are the chosen ones and we are the chosen people. So I don't know why I gotta keep going back and forth of who the chosen ones and who the chosen people is, because out of all the nations and dynasties of the world, just like who people pay attention to, who people care about, who wait on the latest this and latest that, CoverGirl, MTV, all different types of stations wanna broadcast the most tropical Negroes or niggas or black people or Hebrew Israelites, because we got the gold in us. And Dick Gregory knew that, you know. He Malcolm X knew that, you know. All the great ones knew who we was. Marcus Garvey, the great Huey Newton, Bobby Seale, and Ezra Thomas, if I can get his name wrong.
Gandhi too.
Yeah. But we just want to spare some light on this man's name, man. We just want to get some respect where respect is due, man. That man, he really had to feel something in his soul and inside of him to really go hard like how he went and really have a name in this real world. And just like, you know, Yahweh Shai, Christ himself, that nobody paid attention to him and nobody didn't care about what really happened in reality, that nobody want to speak about, but we know what really happened. And same thing of the brother Dick Gregory life. Like, he did a lot of things and nobody want to speak about it. They don't want to introduction it. They don't want to educate it to all the universities and different courses and make him a proper cool person of history, historian, right. Scientist.
And not to mention, this man was multi-talented. He was an author, a comedian, philosopher.
Yeah, great comedian.
So much he did. For us, it's just, he was just a multi-talented man.
Ain't nobody want to shed no light but me and Roach. So me and Roach do this. You see what I'm saying? And other people that cared about the legacy of our people and the struggle and the overcoming of our people to see our people in a greater light and a greater land and a greater place in life. But we going to shoot to this video that of the great Dick Gregory. And we're going to give y'all a couple of minutes of this, so y'all go do y'all research. This is Basket Live 2.0. Go follow Justin Roachy, a.k.a. Roach, on IG or Twitter, and myself on Facebook and IG. I'm lit on IG. Everybody knew that. I'm lit on IG. Shouts out to the brother that just got killed in North Philadelphia. I know his last name was John David Jones. We ain't gonna forget you. Justice for David Jones. We ain't gonna forget you. That enough is enough. And if a new Dick Gregory, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Marcus Garvey, Huey Newton, Bobby Seale, Mr. Edges will come through the roots that the Most High deal with us with and give us the power with, we're going to give justice to our people. So justice for David Jones. And if the great Dr. Dick Gregory was here, he'd be screaming justice for David Jones. That nobody probably know who David Jones was and is. But that's another black man that got killed by the police officers in North Philadelphia. So I want all y'all prayers to go out to that brother and his family. We throwing a hood for Trayvon Martin. And we're going to give y'all this video because we love you.
Officers to county jails. He speaks not only to bring attention to his current passions, health and nutrition. The agitator has some very definite opinions to share on just about everything. Most often, it's social justice.
Understand your power. We black folks in America last year, 28% of every Cadillac sold in America last year, black folks bought it, but we don't demand 28% of the jobs. We don't demand that General Motors hurry up and get out of South Africa. Think about a system that spends more money to put you in jail than it would cost to send you to Harvard. And you black folk, y'all the last ones ought to do crime. Because you know you're not gonna get a fair shake when you get caught. And you poor white folks, who you know, you ain't number niggas. That's right. Oh, you know that.
What about the word nigger? You use it, you've used it here, you use it in your speeches, you use it in books. To a lot of people, it's still a red flag word.
Well,
to a lot of people, it's still an uncomfortable word to hear.
Well, I have to explain that two ways. One, I'm a social satirist. And I take privileges that social satires are able to take. You have to bring it out. And you have to talk about it. We black folks use the word nigger more in one day than all the white folk put together could use in a lifetime. We use it different, we use it affectionate, but you have to bring it out and bust it up and throw it down and knock it down, and then it's over. One thing we black folks got to do, we got to start, we got to admit, there is some culture difference between black folks and white folks in America. And a lot of you black folks get around white folks, you even eat different. Yeah. Y'all get around white folks, y'all be eating so quiet, when you be in my house, I can hear your lips moving in the basement. Yeah. And some of you black folks got nerve enough to get around white folks and try to eat fried chicken with a knife and a fork. And you know spiritually that don't even feel right. And eat it and don't get no grease on yourself. Come by my house, get grease all over my drapes.
There's a whole generation that grew up listening to Dick Gregory.
I'm enough to get around white folks and try to eat fried chicken with a knife and a fork. And you know spiritually that don't even feel right. And eat it and don't get no grease on yourself. Come by my house, get grease all over my drapes.
There's a whole generation that grew up listening to Dick Gregory.